Hey everyone, welcome to the presentation of my thesis for MSc in AI and ML submitted to Liverpool John Moores University. My name is Shakib Ahmed Pasha and the title of my thesis is Action Recognition from Images Using Contextual Cues. I worked under Minesh Matthews as the thesis supervisor for this work. To begin with, let us understand what an action recognition is, specifically with respect to the images. So basically, action recognition is a two-stage process with localization and classification. So what this means is taking an example of this image itself. First of all, from the image, we are supposed to localize the region of action. For instance, in this case, there are bounding boxes around the primary subjects. So primary subjects can be either a human or an animal. But in our case, we are focusing on human subjects. So having recognized the region of action, the next task is to identify the actual class of action. So this is the classification task. This makes it a higher level visual recognition task than just an image classification task. Usually when we say action recognition, we typically associate with the videos itself. And that has been the case with the latest research in this area. They typically work with video data set. But why do we need action recognition specifically from images then? There are some specific advantages for it. For one, videos are nothing but a sequence of images. And if we have a way to recognize action from images, that can naturally form a part of the video recognition pipeline. Helping improve the accuracy of the model itself. Then there are use cases for memory constrained devices. With the industry moving towards IoT and the computing at the edge, most of these devices at the edge are memory constrained devices. In such case, working with videos need a lot of computing resources. But if the recognition can happen on an image, that definitely helps in such cases. Then there are also some use cases where real-time inferencing is required. And as a baseline, we can consider that recognition from videos will always be slower when done with images themselves. So definitely images, recognition from images should help here. And there are some specific applications for action recognition from images. For instance, semantic image search, then archiving for digital libraries, and so on and so forth. So with these applications in mind, we believe that action recognition from images is required, and it definitely helps in the visual recognition world. Let us understand why this task is challenging when compared to action recognition from videos. So like I mentioned before, action recognition from videos is benefited by the presence of the time domain features. So what that means is, let us consider this example wherein I've captured a part of the video represented by a sequence of frames. And if we look at the frames for a particular action, there's a lot of flowing pixels between the frames, which definitely adds a lot of information, and that would aid in action recognition. But this type of information will not be available when we are working with just the images. So this makes it a bit difficult compared to a video data set. Even for a human eye, recognizing a particular action from a still image is pretty difficult, because in some cases different actions are ambiguous in nature, and recognizing them from a still image becomes difficult. Like for instance, in this case, deducing if a person is actually walking or running is pretty difficult. Naturally, the ground truth label was marked as walking, while our model wrongly predicted it as running. So these are inherent issues that is there in the action recognition when done on still images. Then finally, the task of localization itself, that becomes a that is pretty challenging when compared to videos itself. So in case of videos, it will be as simple as just taking a difference between the subsequent frames to get the region of action. But in case of images, the model has to first localize the primary subjects and then do a classification of those. Having looked at why this task is challenging, we then look at what improvements can be done or based on the latest state of the art work to improve action recognition from images. So one such approach that has been tried out in the latest state of the art work is to consider context, contextual information available in the image for action recognition. So what that means is, let us again consider this image as an example. So the action being performed here is riding a bicycle. So for this recognition, there are some contextual cues that are helpful in recognizing the kind of action being performed. For instance, the pose of the person itself, then the presence of the bicycle itself is again one more contextual cue. Then the presence of the pavement on which this the bicycle is being ridden is another cue that would aid in recognizing the action. But there are also some misleading contextual cues that are present in this image. For instance, the presence of the boat, presence of the canal underneath. So these are all kind of misleading contextual cues which will confuse the model. So the main essence of this is captured in a seminal work titled Scene Perception by Biedermann and others, which was published in 1982. So they conducted multiple experiments to identify how context plays a role in recognizing an action in the image. And so they concluded with the following points. So first of all, they identified five conclusive relations, like interposition, support, probability, position, and familiarity of the size of the primary subject, which contribute towards improving the recognition performance. What they also concluded is out of context objects are misleading in a image. Then they identified that any secondary objects other than the primary objects themselves, if they violate these five conclusive relations, it doesn't really matter for the final recognition performance. And then what they underlined is the normal relation aids. Normal in this case is these five conclusive relations. They aid in recognition, while the violations of any of these five relations confuse the model and we end up with wrong predictions. So this kind of leads us to believe that context plays a very important role in visual recognition task, and when incorporated in the model, it definitely helps improving the model accuracy. Then we start looking at some of the inspirations that we derived out of the latest state of the art work in this field. The first inspiration came in the form of contextual RCNN. So this was a model proposed by Giorgia Gioxari and others. So this is actually based on another object recognition model called FastRCNN, proposed by Ren and others. Though FastRCNN is an object recognition model, this is still relevant for our case, because object recognition in itself has the same stages of first localizing the object and then recognizing the object. So the same stages are required in our case as well, wherein we have to first localize the action and then classify the action. So naturally, object recognition becomes a equivalent model for us. But anyway, action recognition is a higher level visual recognition task when compared to just the object recognition. Because apart from recognizing the object itself, we will have to figure out what action is being performed, which is different compared to just recognizing the object. Now coming back to fast RCNL, so this was a model which was proposed at the time of contextual RCNL work, which was a leading state-of-the-art method for object recognition. So if you look at fast RCNN method, it involves initial few convolutional layers to extract the images. So this is based on ImageNet architecture. Then it has a region proposal mechanism. So in case of fast RCNN, they used traditional selective search algorithm to come up with region proposals. And these region proposals were actually projected on the convoluted feature maps available. And when these region proposals were projected, they were kind of wrapped into a fixed size vectors through this ROI pooling layer to get finally ROI region vectors corresponding to different regions of the image. Finally, they were passed through some fully connected layers to get the object class classification and then the bounding box regressor for the localization itself. So building upon this, the contextual RCNN model actually takes the initial few layers from fast RCNN itself, and they modify the final few layers of the fast RCNN to incorporate the contextual information and detect the action being performed. So as you can see, till the ROI layers, the model is same as fast RCNN. And then we differentiate by having two arms of the network. The top arm is respected to the primary region, which is a ground truth label given in the image itself. So for instance, in this case, this red box is the primary ground truth box around the primary subject, and that is passed through this upper layer and is to get a score which denotes score of this region against each of the action classes. Then the lower arm is the score for different secondary regions from the same image. So we get scores of all of these secondary regions, and then we pick a max of each of these scores across the classes and then add it to the primary score. Finally, this addition in a way is supposed to capture the contextual cues coming from the secondary regions, adding on to the primary region and helping out in detection of action. Then the second inspiration came in the form of improvement over the fast RCNN method as a base network. So faster RCNN was proposed by Ren and others, and this was a evolutionary improvement over the fast RCNN. So when compared to fast RCNN, the only difference in this network is this region proposal network, which replaces the selective search for ground up region proposals. So selective search is a pretty slow network, and that used to be the bottleneck in fast RCNN network, but in case of faster RCNN with RPN, it becomes pretty fast. So this RPN network is actually learned together with the entire network, and the inferencing using these RPN networks is pretty fast. Then the final inspiration for us came in the form of the gating module. So this was proposed by a method called self-selective context, proposed by Murat Kilikaya and others. So this work was done in the context of human object recognition by taking some contextual cues. But this is relevant for us as well, wherein we have a primary region and then we have some secondary regions for the contextual cues. And if you could use the same similar approach of gating module to extend the primary region, it should help us in the accuracy. So looking at this gating module itself, what it does is it takes the human object interaction and then the corresponding contextual cues for that human object interaction. They learn parameters alpha, which are supposed to capture the correlation between the human object interaction with that of the contextual information. And then finally, the correlated information is concatenated to the human object interaction to get an extended feature map. So with all these three inspirations, we came up with the final model that looks with the final model that looks like this. So as you can see, so we have three arms in our final network. So initial few layers are same as the faster RCNN pipeline. Then we branch out with the three arms. So the first top arm is supposed to represent the primary region around the primary subject, which is the ground truth bounding box. Then the middle arm represents the secondary region proposals that are coming from RPN network. Then we implemented a gating module, which would capture the correlation between the each of the secondary region with that of the corresponding primary region. And these alpha parameters are learnt along with the entire network. So this correlated features are actually concatenated with the primary features to get an extended feature map. And that is passed through a scoring network to get a score of each of the action against this particular image. Then the lower arm is again a new addition that we did. So this is basically contextual relevance arm. So this is supposed to represent the context of the entire image and how it is related to the particular action being performed in that primary region. So as you can see, we considered the entire image as the region for this arm of the network, and then we pass it through fully connected layers to get a score of contextual relevance. So moving on, with this network, we are happy to report that we got a much better mean average precision when compared to the base R-star CNN method, and that is captured here with the numbers that we got. So we got the mean average precision of 95.4 when compared to 87.9 by the base R-star CNN method, which was quite an improvement in this regard. Then another interesting point to note here is we got pretty consistent results across the action classes, which was not the case with the base R-star CNN method. So if you look at the base R-star CNN method, the accuracy was high only for a few of the classes. For instance, playing instrument, riding bike, riding horse, and using computer. So the reason for that is all of these classes involved secondary cues which are prominent in the image. For instance, playing instrument involves the instrument itself, which is quite prominent in the image. Similarly, for riding bike, there is a presence of bike, and for riding horse, there is a horse itself. And for using computer, there is a computer which are prominent cues in the image. But for other classes where there are not so prominent cues in the form of secondary regions, the base R-star CNN method didn't perform so well. But in our case, we seem to have captured those nuances in the contextual cues coming from the entire scene of the image itself, which seems to be performing pretty well for us when we see that the performance is pretty consistent across all the action classes. So with this improved results, we wanted to understand what part of the what components of our model helped in this improved result, for which we carried out an ablation study. So we did a three-part run, and this run was performed on a limited set of training data. So we picked about 1,000 samples from the training set and about 500 samples from the test set to do this ablation run. We ran all the three different models in for 30 iterations, and we kept rest of the network parameters constant across the three runs. Looking at the three runs, so the first run was done for base R-star CNN method, Then we added just the gating part of the network to the base method. And then for the final run, we added the contextual relevance arm from our network, which is basically the entire final network that we came up with. So when we looked at the results of this ablation run, we identified that the final form of our network, which is with gating and contextual relevance features, that performed the best across the three runs. And it converged pretty early in the training, around 10th epoch. But interesting to note here is that the intermediate network with just the gating component didn't really perform that well when compared to the base network. But one thing to note here is that this intermediate gating model seems to be helping with faster convergence of our network. So as you can see, our final model and the model intermediate model, they both are converging around the same epoch. And so we believe that this gating model is helping us to converge faster, and while the fully populated model is actually helping improve the results. So now we look at some of the improved results that we got compared to the base R-star CNN method. So first class where we came up with good results is the jumping class. So as you can see, so these are all the examples that our model predicted correctly. So if we look at jumping class, it appears that it is generally an outdoor activity with a specific pose of a primary subject involved in all the cases. And in these three images where there is a water beneath the person itself, so that seems to be another contextual cue that picking up, and that's how we see that an improved result on the jumping class. For phoning class, we see that it is generally an indoor activity with the presence of phone in hand itself is another contextual cue, and our model seems to be capturing these cues pretty well, and we have good results on the phoning class as well. Having looked at all the improvements that our model did, but we found that there is still some room for improvement. So one such room for improvement is there's definitely a need for more varied data for each of the classes. So we have two interesting examples over here where we got interesting predictions from our model. So first of all, in this image, we see that a person is playing basketball, is jumping in air. So the ground truth label was jumping, but our model predicted it to be playing instrument. And we believe this prediction is coming from the fact that generally in the data set, the playing instrument class has all the examples in that class seems to be playing instrument indoors in a dark setting with some lights on. So these seems to be contributing towards our model predicting it to be playing instrument while the actual label is jumping. So we believe if we have more data sets for jumping in this setting, our model would have picked up those cues well and probably improved the performance here. Similarly, in this example, the ground truth label is taking photo while our model predicted it to be phoning. And again, this prediction seems to be coming out of the fact that people phoning behind a phone booth which has a tiled windows in front of them. So this seems to be matching that setting, and that's why our model is predicting it to be phoning. So if we have more taking photo classes with similar settings, we hope that our model would be able to capture. Moving on, we believe that there is a need for improved region proposal network as well. For instance, in this example, we see that the actual ground truth label is riding bike while our model predicted it as riding horse. And the reason for this prediction seems to be the fact that the region proposal that we came up with has not captured the bicycle being ridden. So it is actually cropped it till the hand itself, and we believe that this is probably misunderstanding the hand for a horse, and that's how this riding horse prediction comes about. So we believe that if we have an improved region proposal which would have captured the bicycle itself, then the prediction would have been a lot different. Then another interesting example is in here, where a person is actually riding the horse, but he's also reading a book while being on a horse. So the ground truth label for this involves both riding horse and reading, while our model predicted only the riding horse. So riding horse is the prediction that we picked up for the final results. That seems to be missing the fact that these are ambiguous label, and that there are two labels against a single primary region. So we believe this in such cases, having a better or a different metric which will capture multiple a kind of multiple classes prediction, then this would have not penalized our results so much. Then finally, we also found a few examples in the data set that we picked up where the ground truth labels were not proper. Like, for instance, in this case, though the ground truth label is wrongly marked as riding horse, which is definitely not the case, our model predicted it correctly with a class called riding bike. So we believe that having a better data set with a good quality of labels should definitely help with improved results with our model. So having seen all these limitations, so we believe that these are the immediate future scope of work items that can be picked up right away. So one such work item is to probably improve the resolution of the RPA network to come up with higher resolution region proposals, which will aid in capturing small scale regions in the entire image. Then we believe that we should experiment this with our model on different data sets, probably having varied examples for each of the classes, and then probably also having good quality of labels. So running this with different data set should help us capture the correct results for our model. And then we also believe that we should work on capturing different evaluation matrices with our model and different data sets, so that we work around the problem of having ambiguous action labels for a single region. So that kind of concludes our work. Before closing out, to recap on our work. So first we looked at what action recognition is in still images and how it is helpful and how that is challenging as well. Then we looked at how context plays an important role, and when incorporated, it will aid in action recognition accuracy. Then we also looked at our improved model architecture with the novel gating module and the novel contextual features that we added, and how it helped improve the results compared to the base model, which was a state of the art till now. And then we finally closed out with looking at some of the future scope of work that can be picked up based on this research. That's about my thesis. Thanks for the time.